Let's face it, you're dealing with hot things, you're dealing with oil, you're dealing with fire, sharp knives.
Super dangerous, really.
Super dangerous, yeah. You know, you gotta be paying attention.
Today, we are gonna be talking about
our worst kitchen injuries.
There's like nothing but getting injured in
the
kitchen.
I mean, arms, battle wounds.
I am very, very clumsy.
You invent ways of hurting yourself.
You can tell what kind of cook a person is how many burns or cuts they have.
I heal up quick, all mine went away.
All right, so my injury, it was involved with brunch, which is my favorite service, by the way.
Really? No, yeah. It's not.
Yeah, it's my favorite.
I love brunch. Says no one ever,
ever
in the history of being a cook.
Put me in. Look, listen, any spot in New York right now, you want me to work brunch, come holla at me. I charge a lot of money before
I
go.
Yeah, dude.
Come holla at me, I'll take care of you. You give me 4 pans, I'm ready.
No problem.
Yeah, so we were, you know, everybody was busy getting ready for service. It was a bigger tray than this. It was the long one.
Full sheet.
Full sheet tray of bacon. It was
hot.
Cooked, hot bacon, oil.
Oh, everywhere. I know where this is going.
Yeah. And so somebody had put it on top of a double stack
hot
oven. And I was, you know, I was running service. So I was like, yo, what the f is this? Who put this up here? And I'm like about to rip somebody a new butthole, but then I pulled it and it splashed all up into my arm.
So you pulled it and all that hot fat,
yeah,
just went bloop, tsunami.
And then in a matter of like 30 seconds, it just bubbled. Like
instant bubble. Big.
So I just took my knife and just popped it, boom. And then all that came out and I ripped the skin off. And then I put the ointment on there, wrapped it up, and then plastic wrap.
Saran wrap, yeah, that's the
then,
move.
And then I went and worked service. I literally fired that person because that was,
you know, dangerous, man.
It was still cooking up there, and you know the oven's at 500. You know what I'm saying? And that was the most like excruciating. That took 6 months to heal.
That's yeah. Serious
yeah,
burn,
yeah,
man.
That was
you know, you basically deep fried your forearm.
Yeah. Went to the spot and they were like, "Yo, that's disgusting. You got to get out of work." I said, "What do you mean get out of work? Like who's
yeah,
gonna
no,
work
that's
the
X-ray
station?"
Yeah. And you know, I mean, not to belittle your forearm, mm-hmm, but could you imagine? You know, someone did
the
that,
face.
A shorter person or
yeah,
any other, someone,
yeah,
boom, on their face.
You gotta be careful. You gotta pay attention. And you also, you know, stop grabbing stuff without a towel. You know, that's kind of the key right there, too. You gotta be aware of the other people in your kitchen. Say behind, say corner, say
hot,
say cold, too, you know? Nitrogen is a cold burn.
Safety first. Table 6 can wait.
My injury story is about a mandolin cut. I was on the salad station, Chris. I think it was a Friday or Saturday night service and I was hammered. And like, I just had like the tickets all lined up and it's just like the machine's going. And you're just like going, doing this. You got your things going and I nicked it. And this one was just, we've nicked our fingers on mandolins, but this one was a scorcher. I mean, meaning like it just wouldn't stop. I put that spray on where you try to get the blood to stop going.
Yeah.
You wrap it, you put a Band-Aid, and I put one of these onto the finger condoms, which is also really sexy.
Yeah.
And then I continue to work because when you're in the weeds and you're in that mindset, you like, you're just trying to continue.
Yeah.
And what I noticed as I was continuing to work was that the finger condom was just getting more and more filled with blood.
Yeah.
So it was just like puffing up. And it was an open kitchen, so as the servers would like take a dish, they were just kind of like, oh my God, like is she really doing this? Because they're obviously like seeing what's happening. And then before I knew it, the finger condom exploded. And I knew that because there was blood on the tickets and there was blood on my station and the saute cook just stopped everything and actually pointed to me and said, stop,
yeah,
get off the line. Reset and
yeah.
And honestly I should have done that like way before,
right.
But when you're just like
you're
crazy
just
you,
keep
don't,
going. Yeah.
You don't think about it.
It's bad enough like when you're, you know, just when you hurt yourself in your home kitchen, but when you are in an environment in which you are making food for other people who are paying for that food,
right,
like it's a whole different situation because it's hard to even explain, like, you know, you getting pulled off your station meant that somebody else had to go and cover you, and then like
which
diminished the overall, you know, efficiency.
Oh, efficiency,
of
you're
the
already
kitchen.
Behind. And honestly, that's the whole thing. You don't think like that in that logical way where you're like, safety first, all of that stuff. You're just like, how do I push these plates out? How do I clear the board?
Right.
You know? Moral of the story, take a beat.
Noted.
Yeah.
The thing I always say about mandolins
yeah.
is like, don't get greedy. I mean, which is hard in a restaurant because your like chef will come by and be like,
Yeah. Don't take it to the very end. Like, that's, leave that zucchini. 80, leave that cucumber.
80% yield at best. Just let it go.
That'll be a little Scooby snack for me, you know?
It's not a very long story, but I'll tell you, I did stage for a while at the, in Danielle, at Danielle, in the pastry kitchen, where I was just a peon. And one time I was taking something out of the oven and I just hit my face like this somehow.
Oh, with the hot thing?
So I just had a big slash burn, which it wasn't bad at all. It was just so embarrassing.
So clumsy.
I mean, I was already like the lowest on the totem pole, and then I was a freak.
And it was like, oh, she's not.
She can't touch anything in
no
here.
No butter. Yeah. She can't touch the butter.
I had a scar on my face for a while. It was very embarrassing to tell people why. I think if you're gonna be cooking, as much as we cook, you're gonna burn yourself. There's just really no way around it.
Yeah, it's just inevitable.
But you get used to it. I have now talked myself into not feeling, like, you can talk yourself out of pain. Have you noticed that?
You've only burned yourself.
I know, I've never been to the hospital with a burn or something like that, so I don't really know.
You know, I had a few injuries, nothing crazy in kitchens, more outside of the kitchen, to be honest. But my the one that came to mind was a few years back. It happened when we were shooting a video. Back in the day, we did a camping episode for It's Alive. You know, a guy cut his thumb off doing this. Not to go jinxing myself. I got a little boo-boo. And I was cutting potatoes, you know, over a bowl, little potato. We were making breakfast, right? I was just on autopilot, going. Someone was talking about something, you know, Vinny was yapping about something and telling me something about bow hunting. I chipped up and I just moved. And it was, I mean, I was cutting quarter inch potatoes and it's brand new mandolin. Oh, dude, it was just all of a sudden there was a quarter inch coin to Brad's fingertip in the potato. No. Blood everywhere. You could see like layers of like fat. And I mean, it was gone. It kind of grew back, you know, like a lizard or something. Yeah. Like your fingertips, they come back, you know, but
those are the worst ones.
Took
man.
A bit of nail. Yeah. It was literally a quarter inch chip.
Yeah, those are
might even been a little bigger than quarter inch. It was heavy. I tell you what, I'm pretty good with injuries and stuff like that. But you know, we were shooting and I got a little lightheaded from it.
Did you MacGyver it?
Dude, we wrapped it up with a newspaper and electrical tape. And the show went on, baby. In 2 hours, we wrapped up that video. And I mean, I had like this freaking, you know, this big plug thing on my hand.
How long did it take to heal?
Oh, weeks.
Yeah, dog.
It was a gnarly one. Dog. You know it's bad when you can see like fat.
Oh, God.
Yeah, moral of the story there is, you know, even if it's something you've done a million times and you're on autopilot, slow down, man. Think about what you're doing, especially something with a mandolin.
Don't get too comfortable.
Number one rule with a mandolin is what?
Uh-huh.
Open.
That's right.
And I was like this.
But that's even worse too, though. That's worse though too if you get one of those sliced ones.
Oh, if it's a brand new one, I've been screwed. Shave the whole head. Woo! Next topic.
So my story involved one of these guys. Do you remember the old-fashioned Cuisinart blades where they were serrated? So I was cooking just like by myself at home in Brooklyn at the time, and I was cooking barefoot.
Ugh.
And managed to knock the food processor blade off of the counter. And it wasn't like spinning wildly. It wasn't like twisting in midair, you know? It was not like some kind of like, you know, sort of cut-in shot from like outtake from like Wanted. It just like boop. And it fell perfectly right on the top of my foot and opened up a wide gash because of the serration and gravity, it just penetrated.
Oh my God.
And I was like, oh, you know, and it's like, you know, you now have a bloody foot.
Well, you're like seeing the blood first before even the pain kicks in, right?
That second in which you have to ask yourself, how bad is this?
Yeah.
And in this case, like, it was kind of a bad one. And so it's like, you are now, like that person you swore you'd never become, like sort of stomping around in like a bandaged foot in New York City, you know, and like figuring out like, okay, what do I do? Go to the ER, this or that. I text a photo to my brother-in-law, who's a surgeon, and was like, how bad is this? Do you think I need stitches for sure?
The question always with cuts is, do you need stitches or not?
Do you need stitches?
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah, I think you're definitely gonna need stitches.
Oof.
But he was like, you know what? Let me take a break from work, come uptown, I'll stitch you up myself. I meet him at his apartment, I take a cab up there, he brings a suture kit, gives me a tetanus shot, you know, the painkiller thing, you know, stitch me up, boom, couple of stitches. Moral of the story, I mean, could I be in my running shoes still? Yeah, I could be, but I'm not.
We have steel toe shoes in the kitchen.
Yeah, like it's gonna take a lot you know, for a knife to kind of like go straight through that thing. It's gonna certainly slow it down. But seriously, like, take your time to like do everything like right
properly,
rather than like rushing in, you
honestly,
know,
that was
and
one
having
of the,
a short view.
One of the first lessons I learned also in a like a professional kitchen is the speed will come. If you know how to do it and learn how to do it right the first time, mm-hmm. you're just gonna get better.
Like, yeah, you gotta respect the kitchen.
My story, Tyler's kitchen. I am making fried tortillas.
Okay.
So usually there's a mold. You have to take a basket out, bend the tortilla, the raw tortilla, mm-hmm. around it, and mm-hmm. then just singe it in the oil like a deep fryer. So I'm standing on this end, and you're dipping it in. Mm-hmm. I had to do maybe 100, 150. Maybe after a while you develop a rhythm, and then you start thinking, oh, I got this. Mm. And then I get distracted, and I dip my whole hand into the fryer. And it wasn't for long. But it's only me and my manager. You run to the pharmacy, which is around the corner. Burn cream, nothing's working. Pain, like crazy. Of course, in that world, you can't like leave because it's almost time to open. You know the pain where it actually hurts your brain?
No.
I went back to the pharmacy the third time, and the only thing there was Preparation H.
Okay.
I'm like, hey, that might work. You know, it's numbing. Thing
was
that.
Why didn't you go to the hospital?
Because I have to work in like a couple hours. Hospital?
I don't know.
So I put it on. Ta-da!
Preparation H?
I use it every time I get burned.
Huh. Who knew?
The moral of the story is you respect the kitchen, get your ego out of there, because it will humble you.
I was very humbled.
Yeah.
That's good advice.